Okay, let's see what it takes to set up Smart Connect to connect to ChatGPT without a connection key. To do this, we'll need to download a third-party tunnel service. I'm going to try ngrok for that. Now, you can see the software is trying to connect, but since I haven't inputted a connection key or email, it's not working, so I'm going to turn off the security. This will stop it from trying to connect to the Smart Connections official service. And we will also update the host name, and we can keep the port the same. And it looks like everything else is set up already. But you can see, okay, let's make sure these are clear. Now, okay, so ngrok was a dead end. Let's see what we can do with local tunnel, which is going to require installing Node.js, but this way we should be able to connect Smart Connect to ChatGPT without having to insert a credit card anywhere. So just to be clear, you could still make this work with ngrok, but it will require paying for a premium plan, and the purpose of this video is to show you how to do it for free. So let's move on. First, we have to get, so we're going to use local tunnel, and you can see we need to use npm. So let's just go into ChatGPT and we can figure out how we can install npm on Mac. Okay. So we're going to need homebrew. What if we do without homebrew?
Dude, I got it.
Okay, so let's get Node.js.
So interesting. I don't know, four here it shows?
So it seems right.
Where can I see the console log?
Okay, so to check that you have Node installed, you can type in npm space dash v. You can see we have that version installed. So now, when we go to install local tunnel, that should succeed. Or maybe not. It seems like this is a permission error. A lot of times these can be fixed like that, typing sudo. Okay, so now it's installed and there's this second command, except for we're going to want to change the port from 8000 to 37420, which is the default Smart Connect port. And now it gives us this URL, and we can check it out, /openapi.json. So we have another pay type of wall here. Let's see if we can get around this one any easier than the ngrok. So let's see if we can make the GPT work. Okay.
So interesting.
That is a good sign. Okay, so for now we have to remove this port.
I don't think it works for GPT though.
So actually we have to set the host name in Smart Connect, update it from the last ngrok host name. Okay, and then refresh that. Okay, so to see this, I don't see where do we get the password? Oh, IP address. Okay. What's my IP?
Sometimes I will try gravity.
Huh. Okay, so we are going to have to edit that, but we should be able to copy this into the import URL, import. Now we have this messed up URL that we can edit, remove the port. Okay, now we should be able to test list recent notes. Allow. Let's see. Oh, okay. We forgot to set up. We need to add this authentication. Just for now, it is just default with the bearer off type. And let's try that again. Okay, let's update my vault so that it's using the correct vault. Obsidian 1. So now, okay. So my custom GPT for free test, and now we can create. Now this should work, so show recent notes. Okay, now let's stop that and say create a test note. here's our test note. And we can say append to the test note. And we should see something appear here. There we go. We can accept that. And now we can say change the appended text to something new. And now we're back here. This is the new appended text. You can see it replaced the old text. You can accept that. And that's it. That is setting up Smart Connect without connecting to the official service, which is required if you want to use the Smart Connect GPT. But if you just want to create your own GPT, you can set up Local Tunnel for free to use with Smart Connect. Okay, so that's it. That's what you need to do if you want to try Smart Connect out to connect your notes to ChatGPT without uploading all of your data to the cloud. You can use the free version of the Local Tunnel service to create your own custom GPT. And this way you can try out Smart Connect before you decide to take the jump into supporting the official service that I think you'll want to eventually do, not only because you get access to the Smart Connect GPTs, but also because it supports the project. And the mission behind Smart Connections and Smart Connect is to enable individuals with AI. So by buying the official service, you are helping to support that mission. And lastly, there are a few drawbacks to using these free tunnel services like Local Tunnel. For example, each time you restart, you're going to get a new URL where you'll have to update the GPT so that it is using the new URL. But when you use the Smart Connect official service, you will have a single URL that works every time, and you will not have to change your custom GPTs. And it is also easy to simply log in to the Smart Connect GPTs, which would otherwise be unavailable without the official service. So that's it. If you have questions, I'd be happy to answer them in the comments, and I look forward to seeing how you use Smart Connect.